my opinion is that every year, every month, every day, we can see that these couples are giving a lot of different ideas which are making the dancing much more interesting. And the bodies is going to be much more full in the movement, which is also creating us, like teachers, much more ideas to increase this emotion, and then we'll be more interesting day by day. But what I want to ask, say to all the couples that of course it's important that we are making our dance every day more interesting, more characteristics, but don't forget that we have the music to follow, the music to listen, to enjoy every emotion, not to run away all the time, which is in one way is going to be one of the first priority now. I agree, but not 100%.
You just mentioned the importance of emotions. How can you create emotions and give the couples tips to get more emotion, to show more emotion?
Standard dancing is two persons that are going to dance together. And to be able to dance together, we have to listen to each other. We have to speak with our body and to use our emotion together, not individual. This is sometimes that is going to create a problem, mistakes, when we only think about our own. Okay.
Very interesting. Thank you for the interview.
Of course, we know that the center of gravity is the hips line. These are our body. The center of the body, hips line, is the second dimension of the body. The first is the knees, the second the hip line, and the third is the chest. In the second dimension, there is the common center, my and Simona put together. We find, using our knees, to put our body weight connected together. Therefore, this point, this part of our body, is the center of our connection. After, when we move, of course, we have to drive using like priority is the first center, hips line. I go forward, I move back, turning promenade, so everything turns around this center. The second center is on the third dimension, between here. So in that part of the body, you have the third dimension is now body, is high center. Sometimes I must drive the first and finish to using the last final part, uses the second center. Sometimes I activate the second center and really not stop the first, but the first, for the first time, if I dance right range, I don't really stop, but I activate the second center, so the first one is the reaction, what's happened, up of the body. Okay? Promenade, follow with me with some flesh.
Hey, 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 hey. quando vuoi mi fa stare male sempre sei complice delle idee di ricominciare prendi la mia identità e svolti appesi la mia realtà tra di noi nuova luna c'è già
joint under the body is to react. If you stop, it's very easy to lose the balance. The big difference, the second center and the first one, is when I dance some stop figure, when I dance on the spot, when I don't have movement. So I cannot use the first, but immediately, without movement, I have to activate the second center. Waltz. Just say to you, probably I don't trust me because she's a dance for the rest. I don't really stop the first. I make my very fluid and very oily joint in the under the body, but activate the second center. Same in waltz. The big difference is when I move, when I dance, because I cannot forget the principle of the dance. Foxtrot swing is more progressive swing. So I cannot use, first of all, the pendulum swing action. So sometime, the way I use the two center is a little bit different because we turn around the speed. In waltz we have one speed, in foxtrot we have another speed. If I dance a natural turn in waltz, I produce speed using body weight. So my body speed and my leg speed travel in the same time. So when I do speed here, I will do speed in my leg. When I dance the half swing, I reduce speed. So I find that the last part of the energy acceleration, I control the speed using my legs and I control it using my body. Doesn't mean if I activate the center, but it's not creating speed. So in waltz we have leg speed and body speed same time, when you release, same time. In foxtrot, this is a bit different. Because if, can we have a few bars on the foxtrot? If you listen music, of course, you know, there are four beats and not three like in the waltz. So four beats, it means that it's different speed completely. So if I want to dance fella step, grab a step, fella finish, I have to respect the timing first. One, two, three, four. Slow. Quick, slow. Quick, slow. Quick, slow. If I dance, same speed, body like in balls. I try to make speed control. Speed control.
Here comes the Spider-Man. Like a streak of light. He arrives just in time.
His attitude is much more similar in balls because we go. We try to find the speed when we go down. Yeah. Quick, slow. And this is in one way is better, in another way is worse than before. Actually, sometimes I have to control the speed. In most, when I use, I move. I move also, but in a different speed. With the second center, I move more quick, and when I create acceleration with my feet, quick, I have to make slower. I have to control the second center, otherwise I push or attack the leg space. Two bars of four.
Spider-Man does whatever a spider
can. I don't use him really tall. Otherwise, the second center don't continue, don't use, don't move, don't really lose the speed. Because still, this is stopping this way. Of course, I have to use also my toes, but only when my feet is back. If I dance, if I finish, flat toe, I make accent, deceleration, I control the second center, is when pass under body is toe.
Just like flies, look out. Here comes the Spider-Man. Candle, and she showed me the way.
try to develop these already very good couples and a good training camp, their attitude in the body. So sometimes the body weight, the body, the top part of the body is just not clear enough. So I try to explain the two center for to try to dance more the body in the musicality system.